Hello everyone, my name is Jerry King and I teach at the University of Alabama in Birmingham in the School of Health Professions. Today we're going to do a case study to talk about multiple different healthcare careers other than being a doctor and a nurse. Everyone has heard of a doctor and a nurse. We're just going to introduce some other things. So at this point, I'd like to introduce you to my son. My son is around 4 or 5 years old. He's a healthy boy, future linebacker at UAB. But as a good dad, I come home from work one day and my son meets me at the door and I lean down and I give him a kiss. And when he gives him a kiss, I notice that he tastes salty. Now my son should not taste salty. As a good dad, I'm gonna call the pediatrician, I'm gonna take him to the doctor. One of the issues with physician offices today is they're so busy, they can't see all of their patients. Case in point, I got sick one February with a sinus infection. My doctor's office told me they were booked up and they could see me in October. Well, that's too long to wait for me to see a doctor, especially if something is wrong. So physician's offices, to solve that problem, are now hiring physician assistants and nurse practitioners to work in their office. These physician assistants function just like a physician. They see patients, they diagnose, they order the treatments, and they take complete care of the patients. They just have to have a physician overseeing them, which means they can call or contact them if they need help. So the PA walks into the room, introduces themselves to us, takes a brief medical history, finds out what's going on with my son, and I tell the physician assistant, my son tastes salty. So the physician assistant is going to order some lab work, and the lab samples at that point will be drawn by a phlebotomist or a medical technologist. And when that medical technologist completes the body samples or the fluid samples, they're going to take those samples to a lab. One of the tests that they're going to run is called a sweat chloride test. So when they take that sample to the lab, they'll give the sample to a specialist in the lab. That specialist is called a clinical laboratory scientist. And that clinical laboratory scientist will run the diagnostic test and then take the information and share it with the physician assistant. My clinical laboratory friends like to call themselves detectives in the medical field. They get all the body samples, all the fluid samples, and they run the test to help the medical team determine what exactly is going wrong with the care or the family member, the patient. So the CLS runs the test, delivers the information back to the PA. The PA walks back into the room, sits down with us and says, Mr. King, I need to tell you that your son actually has a condition called cystic fibrosis. So cystic fibrosis is a genetic disorder that affects the endocrine system and it affects the pulmonary system. So during this time, the PA is going to order a lot of medicines, a lot of different treatments, and a lot of different consults for us to meet with different medical professions to help take care of my son. One of the professions that he's going to, or consults that he orders, will be a physical therapist. We know that the human body fights diseases and conditions better the stronger they are. So that physical therapist will actually sit down and give us some exercises that we can do at home to help keep my son's body straight and in line. One of the other things he's gonna order is a lot of times patients with cystic fibrosis actually will have about 15 to 20 different medications a day. Some of them you take with food, some of them you take without food, some of them you take before bed, sometimes you take them multiple times a day. We're gonna need some help kind of organizing all those medications to make sure we know when to take what medicine and how to take it. So we're gonna meet with a pharmacist, and that pharmacist will actually help us organize a way to make sure we're taking the right medicines in the right way in the right conditions. One of the other professions that the PA is gonna or the physician assistant is going to order a consult with, it's called a respiratory therapist. And that respiratory therapist will come in and take care of the breathing medication that's going to take place, also going to take care of some of the breathing exercises to help make sure my son's lungs are intact. And then another procedure called bronchopulmonary hygiene. And all it is chest percussions where somebody will clap on my son's chest or actually bring a device called a chest vest home so that they can get chest physical therapy, because CF or patients with cystic fibrosis actually have a lot of secretions built up in their lungs and they need to cough it up every day to keep their lungs clean. Because it affects the lungs, at some point in time, either in the doctor's office or at the hospital, my son will actually have to have a chest x-ray done. And that chest x-ray is going to be done by somebody in the radiological specialty field. Another procedure that my son will have done is actually with a nuclear medicine technologist. And that nuclear medicine technologist will work with a respiratory therapist. My son will actually inhale some radioactive materials, and then the nuclear medicine technologist will take a special camera and they'll take pictures of my son's lungs so they can actually see how his lungs are functioning to clean the mucus out and clear the mucus. One of the other components of cystic fibrosis is it is a genetic disorder. My son doesn't want to grow up to be an only child. If he's an only child, he'll be the only one to take out the garbage. He'll be the only one to wash dishes. He'll be the only one to do all the chores. He won't have any siblings to share that with. As a parent, because it is a genetic disorder, I'm going to be concerned about future or other children having that same disorder, or even if my son grows up and gets married, how will his children be affected? So we're going to need to sit down and meet with a genetic counselor, and that genetic counselor will help explain the risk and the possibilities of future children, offspring, whether mine or actually my son's offspring will have either be a risk of a carrier for cystic fibrosis, or if my son's children will actually have the disease. Another consult that the PA is going to order will actually be with an occupational therapist. Having a condition like cystic fibrosis is going to affect every day of our life. That will include vacations, that will include activities of daily living, of getting ready for school. So that occupational therapist can actually sit down and help us explore some options that we may not know about to help us have better care for my son. And because cystic fibrosis affects the endocrine system, there are certain foods that my son will have trouble digesting, or it won't be good for him. He may have trouble gaining weight. So we're gonna actually sit down with a nutritionist, and that nutritionist can help us determine what type of foods to stay away from, or what type of foods are helpful or good for my son and his care. Also, they can help us explore ways to prepare those foods. It may be stay away from fried food. It may be baked or grilled or fast food, but that nutritionist can help us sit down and develop a plan that will help provide the best care for my son so that he can actually have a long and healthy life. One of the situations that's going on with cystic fibrosis, 20 years ago, the average lifespan was not very long. Patients with cystic fibrosis could live till they were 15, maybe 20 years old. Today, with research that's been going on, that lifespan has moved up into the upper 40s and now even in the low 50s in some areas. One of the areas that we'll actually sit down and have a consult with is called a biotechnologist. And that biotechnologist is a specialist in research. They research the drug, what's causing the disorder. They're researching the drug or the disorder to see if there are any new drugs or devices that can provide better care or treatment or cures for the disease. All of these are going to be confusing and important. So at some point in time, we're going to have somebody assigned to us, and they're called a caseworker. And that caseworker can be a registered nurse, or that caseworker can be a social worker. And that registered nurse or social worker, they're almost the quarterback or the coordinator for the healthcare team. They're making sure we get to our meetings, our consults, and we're happy with our care. We're on top of everything. We're following our treatment guidelines. So they kind of organize and just help oversee the total care of everybody, of my son and all the consults. I mentioned earlier about the chest vest. So chest physical therapy, you clap on your son's chest, you do it on the chest, the sides, and the back. You do it in the upper lobes and the lower lobes. And that is great in the hospital when you have active workers who know exactly what you're doing. But when I get home in the afternoon and I'm responsible for cooking supper, my son needs to make sure he gets his therapy, otherwise his secretions build up and he gets complications. I may not have time to stir the spaghetti and crap on my son. So that chest vest is actually a relatively new invention in the last 10 to 15 years, and it's made leaps and bounds of the quality of it. but it actually does chest physical therapy for you. And that came out of research to provide better care for our cystic fibrosis patients at home. The problem with that machine is it can cost anywhere between $15,000 to $20,000, depending on which machine you get. I personally don't have an extra $15,000 to $20,000 laying around that I can just go spend on healthcare equipment. Insurance companies, sometimes they pay for it, sometimes they won't. So at some point in time, we're gonna need to meet with somebody in the healthcare management field. And that healthcare manager is gonna help us understand the insurance components. They'll also help us understand the physical component of the doctor's office or the physician's office of how it's running. So that healthcare manager is going to help us kind of navigate the business side. The other component I want to talk about is biomedical sciences. The biomedical sciences degree will actually help prepare for a job in the lab. So if you want to go work in a research lab, you can do research on cystic fibrosis. If you want to determine what type of new equipment, you may work in another lab of some sort. But the healthcare management degree and the biomedical degree will both prepare you to launch you into one of the other specialties that we've talked about today. In one of the discussions with our caseworker, the question about family vacations came up. How will we, with a child with cystic fibrosis, be able to go to on family vacations away from our local medical physician or our medical healthcare team? How will we feel safe about that? Well, thanks to the profession called health informatics is just the electronic medical education, medical record systems that will allow us to travel across the nation, or different places, and still have access to our medical records if an emergency arises while we're away from our local medical team. So before we wrap up, teachers, if you're watching this, I want to introduce you to a profession or degree opportunity that's relatively new. It's a degree in healthcare simulations. We're already using simulations to teach for our students. You can now actually get the credentials and the extra initials behind your name. So if you're looking for a master's degree, think about healthcare simulation specialized training. When you think about healthcare, usually it's doctor, nurse, or if you have somebody in the healthcare field, or if you're an athlete, maybe physical therapy. Hopefully this presentation will open up doors or open up avenues for you to look at and think, I want some more information about that. If at any point in time you do, you're welcome to reach out to us at the University of Alabama Birmingham School of Health Professions, and we'll help you explore different professions, and we'll also help you explore avenues to get to that profession. Somebody says, I want to be a physician. Well, how do you become a physician? Do you go to a BS degree in biomedical? Do you get a BS degree in healthcare management? Well, it really depends on what type of doctor you want to be. I want to be a physical therapist. Well, we can actually help you explore avenues to get to the PT school and prepare you for preschool, for graduate school, or however you want to go to. Please, if at any point in time you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to us. Thank you.